हाय लक्ष्मी। एंड हाय ऋतिक।
गुड आफ्टर
ऋतिक
गुड मॉर्निंग।
या हाय गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग लक्ष्मी। योर वॉइस इज वेरी लेस टू मी, फेबल टू मी।
हेलो
या लक्ष्मी, नाउ इट्स ऑडिबल।
ओके ओके। ऋत्विक, कैन यू प्लीज शो मी योर आईडी प्रूफ।
यू कैन टेक द आधार नंबर।
या रिमूव इट। नीलेश, प्लीज टर्न ऑन योर वीडियो।
यस इट्स ऑन।
नो, कांट एबल टू सी यू। Ritwik, you can able to see Nilesh image?
No? Oh. Now?
Yeah. Now I can see.
Yeah, now I can see. Thank you.
Cool, thank you.
Yeah, please proceed, Nilesh.
Okay, hi Ritwik. So, I don't have your resume at my desk,
actually,
so please.
No. Please, I have shared my resume on the TAT link only. The TAT link mail only. Yeah, HR has it. Where is she?
Okay, no worries. You can tell me about your year of experience, your current organization, and what profile you have.
Okay. So, I have. So basically, my name is Ritwik, and I live in Dwarka, Delhi. So I have in total of 5 years and 10 months of experience, in which 3 years of includes cloud and DevOps work. So lastly, I was working with Amdocs Pune. So there, I was working in the cloud migration program. So our client was AT&T. So in total, there were 7,000 applications. Amongst those, 4,000 were supposed to be migrated to Azure cloud. So the total number of data centers were 23, and we were supposed to reduce them to 7 for that cost effectiveness. So according to the AT&T, there were 8 to 9 in total of steps in which the applications were migrated. So it all started with the IDO onboarding. So by IDO onboarding, that was an automation process which was AT&T proprietary. So there were certain entries which were supposed to be filled on that particular folder. So it was basically an automation process. So after that, we used to see the two kind of environments in our Azure portal. So one was Azure DevOps, and one was prod, and one was non-prod. After that, we were supposed to create the resources for the production environment according to the requirement based on the target architecture, and we had dedicated detailed documentation for each of the application. So in that way, we used to create the resources for the production environment using Terraform. So in the Terraform code, we used to take the skeleton code, we used to take from the Azure golden images, and then we used to build the code, and then we used to create the resources for the production environment, and then all the server configurations were done accordingly. And in total, there were three kind of environments. One was POC, one was non-prod, and one was prod. So after the cutover of that particular application was done, so the POC environment was destroyed. And other project was BSSC project, in which the developers used to push their code in the Nexus repository, basically Artifactory. And there we used to pull the code in the Bitbucket, and then we used to build that code using Jenkins. And that was, the triggering was basically a manual process 2 times a day. One was in the morning and one was in the afternoon time. And we used to tell the status in the scrum meeting, and whatever the, if there are any errors in the Jenkins pipeline, we were supposed to fix all of them. So in the morning time, we had a meeting with the QA team, and then they used to give us a Word document. According to that, we had to update the code in the Bitbucket. Before that, I was working with the KMG IT services. So soon I joined that company. Cloud was introduced, and as per because that company had various kind of projects. So as and when required, I used to create the resources for the production environment, create servers, and do the migrations. So all those stuff.
Currently, in which company you are associated?
Right now, I am associated with no one. My last working day was 4th of Feb, 2022, because my project got completed in Amdocs. So they asked me to that they are releasing me. So basically, in Amdocs, I was a third-party resource and not they on their payroll.
Okay. Cool. So you are a quick joiner.
Yeah. Immediate joiner.
Immediate
mean it may take around 7 to 10 days, but not more than that.
Okay. So you worked on Azure. What do you mean by tenant ID and subscription? Tenant and subscription?
So tenant, I have not heard, because the subscription was taken by some other team. So if I talk about the subscription, so subscription is basically the person who is trying to take the services of the Azure. So in two of the projects, the BSSC was the internal project of the Amdocs. So the subscription was done by the Amdocs for the BSSC project, and by the AT&T in the cloud migration program. So by tenants.
Then what you did? What you did as a part of Azure DevOps?
No, I used to create the resources for the production environment using Terraform.
How? Using?
Terraform.
Terraform. What kind of resources you created?
All the resources which were present in the target architecture, all the general
like
VMs and load balancers and hard disk and network security groups and the route tables and the DNSs, so all those stuff. So regarding the DNS, we used to use the Cloud Shell. So we had a documentation, and in the documentation we had to give the particular resource ID of that particular application, and then we used to run the commands in the Cloud Shell, and then the DNS entries were done. And other, actually there were 10 to 12 entries at an average.
How are you executing your Terraform code?
We used to, that was connected to the Git, and I used to push that code in the Azure repo, and then used to run the pipeline.
How this pipeline has been configured by you?
So the connection between the Terraform and the Azure was done using PAT token. So in the Terraform, so basically what happens is all the code is done written in the main.tf file only. But we had a different architecture in Amdocs. So every file, let's say there was a different file for each of the resource. Like we have a load balancer, for that we had different file, and for hard disk we had a different file. And then after doing the changes, we used to push the code using Git, and then those changes used to reflect in the Azure repo, and then we used to run the pipeline, and if any error is coming, so we used to fix them, and the resources were reflected in the Azure portal, and then we used to give our feedback. Feedback means status to in the Scrum meeting. And then after we got the VM, we used to do the installations, and if any major installation was supposed to be done, so then we were supposed to do them with their particular administrators of that. Like in Windows installation, if PowerShell is required, so we will get in touch with any system admin, or in Linux, if we have to do a major installation, so we used to ping or get help from the Linux administrator. So number of people in that project were very large. So there were around 18 pods.
But you didn't answer my question. That my question was very straightforward. That how did you configure your release pipeline?
It was already there. I didn't configure any
pipeline. So you didn't work for that, right?
No. Actually, what happened is.
So you worked for L2 support, more.
No. I was not in the support. I was in the cloud migration program, and there was no L1, L2, L3. My designation was a platform engineer, and as a platform engineer, my core task was to create the code in the Terraform, push those changes in the as your repository and create the resources which were given in the target architecture of that particular application and make that.
Yes, so creating the pipeline is also the part of your work, no? Or someone else was doing all this thing.
So by pipeline, I can only.
So you write the Terraform code, you check in the code in Azure DevOps, and after that you are going to deploy those code in different environment. For those, you need the release pipeline. Have you did any release pipeline or something, or it was a manual deployment or what else?
Okay, how is okay, okay. Got it. No, we used to manually create. Like I got it. What you are asking is that if I have pushed any changes, so those should be automatically picked up by the Azure DevOps, and then
No.
The deployments were done by us only as and when required.
Manual deployment.
Yeah, manual deployment. Automation was not required because the timeline was, if every application had a cutover date of around 3 months. So, automation was not required. Automation is required only in those projects in which the daily deployment, the software development is still going on. Those applications which I migrated were already deployed in the on-prem and were supposed to be migrated as it is.
Okay, so I have one question for you. That in Terraform, that have you worked on Ansible?
Ansible in KMG I had worked, but in my cloud migration program Ansible was not required. So, but yes, I have idea about the Ansible.
No, I am asking for hands-on experience, not idea.
No,
okay.
Hands-on experience I have.
Okay.
You can.
And what about Kubernetes services, AKS, Azure Kubernetes services? So, have you worked on
that? The Kubernetes which we use independent way, I have beginner to intermediate knowledge. And in Azure Kubernetes service, so BSSE project was deployed in end-to-end, it was deployed in the Kubernetes. And whenever there were certain problems with the infrastructure, so I used to do the basic troubleshooting there. But it was deployed there only.
Okay. So basically your more work towards your Terraform side, right?
Yeah. But in Kubernetes, if I am given exposure, then I will pick up.
Okay. So I have one question, that in Terraform, you will have main.tf file, right?
Yes.
You will have variable.tf file, right?
Yes.
And you will have tfvars file.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, tfvars file. Now, question to you, that what will happen if your main.tf file is looking for some variable, then which file it will go first?
So basically, main.tf file, it will look for the dependencies. I mean, the Terraform in which I have worked, so there were various kind of dependencies. So those were written in the YAML file. So in the main dot,
So about, have you written any code or something?
Yeah. But not in the, it was not a single main.tf file. It was, different file for different kind of code. So all the files were tfvars files, and the dependencies were stored in the variables.yaml file. And if we want to destroy any resource, so that code was, YAML code was also stored in the variables.
No, I'm not asking for destroy any code at this moment. My question was very simple and straightforward. But anyways, yeah. Now tell me that if your main.tf file is looking for some variable, like subscription ID, okay, and those subscription ID is defined in variables .tf file, okay, but value has not been given.
Okay,
then how will you get the value while getting deployment? Because it will say that okay, value is missing.
Value is missing. So we will have to specify the value in the variable.yaml file. Actually, I am not faced
But
this kind of an issue.
this is that a security breach, na?
Yeah.
If you are giving such kind of value of in your file, and if you are checking the code, anyone can see the value, right?
Yes.
And also the value is different for different environment. So how will you do that?
So this scenario I didn't face. Sorry.
Okay. What do you mean by TF state file? And
please go ahead.
Yeah, but first tell me what is TF state file.
So TF state file is the file which stores the state of the environment or resources which are being created. So the state files are stored in the the general storage which are given by the cloud providers. So for Azure, that will be stored in the containers, and in the AWS, it will be stored in the S3.
Okay, in TF state file, suppose I have defined Terraform, and what do you mean by backend.tf file? Do you know by backend.tf file?
I have heard about backend.tf file, but right now I don't remember.
You don't remember?
Yeah, actually. I have seen in the documentation, but right now I don't remember.
Okay, fine then. Then I think that you have less experience in Terraform, but I evaluated. ADO, I have evaluated. Okay. So do you have any question to me?
No. So you can tell me about the project.
Yeah, the project is associated with Azure DevOps,
okay,
with Terraform, with Ansible Tower, and Azure Kubernetes Services. So at least we are looking at a person who is good in Azure DevOps,
okay,
who is also good in at least Terraform or Ansible or AKS. Yeah.
Okay.
So that's something we are looking for. That.
Okay.
Okay. Thanks, Hrithik. Then nice to talk to you. I will give my feedback to HR, and HR will connect to you. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, sir.